Oh, Craig.
Happy anniversary. 16 wonderful years to the same man. That Hal is one lucky hombre.
Craig, you shouldn't have.
Oh, please. Special gift for a special lady on a special day.
No, I mean, really, you shouldn't have. Aren't only husbands supposed to give you gifts?
Fine, throw it in the trash then.
Hold on. Well, let's see what it is first. Oh, look at, I've been meaning to try this color.
I know, I saw you eyeing it a couple weeks ago.
I didn't know we carried this brand.
We don't.
So where did you see me?
So, big plans for tonight? What are you gonna be wearing?
Oh, it's gonna be great. I have the most perfect red dress. It took me 2 months to save up for it, but it was worth it. Oh, I've been fantasizing about this night forever.
Craig?
Say, Lois, you want to go catch a movie or something over lunch? They're playing my best friend's wedding over in electronics.
No, thanks, I don't...
Fine, forget it.
Gosh! I'm okay!
Craig, thank you so much for lending us your trailer.
I'm just glad someone's finally getting some use out of it. I bought it 15 years ago to take on my honeymoon.
You were married?
No, I live on hope.
Well, thanks again.
You're welcome.
Bye. Goodbye.
You know, this is a little intense. You, me, working this shelf together.
What's intense about it?
I guess nothing. Excuse me.
Mom!
Not supposed to yell in the store.
Not supposed to do that either. Life's funny that way.
Hey, the three musketeers. Athos, Aramis, and you must be Porthos.
You're creepy.
You really shouldn't say hurtful things to grown-ups.
I'm sorry.
That's okay. We're still friends.
Craig, you have got to redo the nail polish. The crystal pinks are mixed with the frosty pinks or mixed with the God knows what.
Right away, Mr. Pitter. Lois!
Hi, Craig.
What are you doing here on your day off?
Oh, I just stopped in with the boys so they could buy me a birthday present.
Oh, it's your birthday? I'd completely forgotten. Seems like any other day, actually.
Yeah, well.
Craig, aisle 7.
Of course, you can't blame me for forgetting. I've been so busy lately. Seems like I'm always hitting the weights at the gym, working on the guns.
Craig, aisle 7.
Yeah, and when I'm not at the gym, I'm usually with my Dixieland jazz group.
Really? What do you play?
I'm the costumer. You know, there are 4 different types of straw hats. And if you ever need those arm garters...
Craig, I can see you.
Bye.
What? What?
Hi, Hal.
Craig, what do you want?
Well, Lois and I had an exchange, and I felt bad, so I'm sure she told you all about it.
No, actually, she didn't say anything. Now, Craig, we're in the middle of
it. Well, it's complicated. You see, I didn't buy Lois a present, even though I wanted to. I thought, this is silly, so I went ahead and got her one, and here it is.
Great. I'll take it into her right now. Oh, such a nice gift.
You know what? Second thought, I can take care of this tomorrow. I'll bring it into work.
Oh, no, it wouldn't be any trouble at all.
Really? No, I'd be happy to take it into her.
Yeah, I'd really hate to put you out.
Don't be silly.
Kevin! Lois, it's crazy stealing your present! It's a bread baker and I paid $129 for it!
Honey?
Here. Shouldn't you be in military school?
Shouldn't you not be in my father's robe?
That is neither here nor there. You are in big trouble, my friend.
I'm in trouble?
Yes, big trouble. I'm telling your mother.
No, I'm telling my mother.
That's my toast.
I can't believe this. I bought my own bus ticket home. I have to spend the whole weekend with you.
I hear you. It's a shame you had to spend your own money. I've discovered a way you can travel for free through the internet.
What, you hacked into an airline's reservation system?
No, that's illegal. I go into a chat room and pretend to be a really hot 18-year-old girl. I'm Debbie. I'm blonde, naive, and I love to wear sundresses. Right now, I'm having a lot of problems at home. Dad's so mean. Going through all these changes, all these strange new feelings. He
Wait,
just doesn't
Greg,
under...
The free travel?
Right. Debbie goes into some chat room, gets real friendly with some lonely guy. Before long, he's willing to pay for a visit. Right now, I'm sitting on a ticket to Tampa. Oh, and I make sure he buys Debbie full fare coach, no restrictions. She may look good in a thong, but she's no dummy. M-Z-R-Y-C. Nice try. What's that supposed to mean?
Mizrick. It's another military term. You know, the helmets that horses wear.
Oh, right. This is nice. Hanging out on a Saturday, playing Scrabble. Couple of guys relaxing. So your folks get along okay?
What?
Nothing. Here we go. Read it and weep.
C-A-T. Hey, that's two cats for you. That's great.
Just playing the tiles I'm dealt. So, you pick up any bad vibes here on the home front, you let me know, right?
Why?
Hey, take it easy, cowboy. Just making small talk.
Okay. I guess they're doing fine.
She's a strong little lady, that mother of yours. Sure, we have our moments at work, but you can't stay mad at that woman for long.
You don't have to live with her.
Maybe you just don't understand her.
What's to understand? She's a total control freak.
Maybe she doesn't get the support she needs here at home.
Well, I wouldn't know since she sent me to military school.
Because you're a spoiled brat. And I'm pretty sure Mizrick ends in a...
Bye now.
Did you enjoy your Lucky 8 shopping experience, gentlemen?
Craig, they're in a hurry.
This won't take a second. Hi, I'm Craig, I'm the assistant manager. I can assure you if there's one thing we value here at Lucky 8, it is customer satisfaction.
We're satisfied.
But you don't sound like it. And please don't feel like you're gonna hurt my feelings because I'm learning here. Now, I'm sure there's something I could do to make this a better experience for you.
Yeah. How about you walk me to every other register in this place and give me every cent you've got?
That's a gun!
Craig, calm down. Just everybody calm down. I've been through this 5 times. We just give them money from all the other registers and they'll leave.
What about the safe?
Safe?
Tea. Safety of the customers.
I'll lock the doors, you start rounding up the customers.
What are you, nuts? We gotta get out of here.
Come on, man. I'm tired of doing these dinky little holdups. Have you ever wanted to do something more important with your life?
What do you mean, like go back to school?
No, man. Like break it into a safe. Do you want to work at Orange Julius forever?
worry, Lois. Everything is gonna be fine. Just fine and dandy. Yeah, keep waving that thing around, buddy boy. You got a big surprise coming.
Craig, that button has been disconnected for over a year.
What? Why?
Because you kept hitting the damn thing.
In an emergency, yes, that's what it's for.
Oh, like an emergency when you saw a bee? Oh, when you saw the big fly that looked like a bee? How about when you thought you saw a ghost?
I'm not saying it was or it wasn't, but you can't tell me what we saw was normal.
All right, you two, let's move it.
He likes waving that around too much. This is gonna end in body bags.
No, Craig, it isn't.
Lois, before we die, I have to tell you something. It's about how I feel.
Craig, no.
But Lois.
Craig, no. This will all be over soon.
Uh-uh. It's not there. Keep looking. Lower.
Craig, Mom said you can give me a ride to study group.
Sure, sure.
What are you doing?
I was reviewing some old security tapes. You know, looking for a pattern, see if anyone was casing the joint. You can't be too careful.
Hey, that girl's stealing something.
Oh, I didn't notice that. I'd better review her other tapes then.
Wait, are there cameras all over this place?
Oh yeah, they're everywhere. Pharmacy, ATM, the bathroom. Yep, a lot of cameras.
Is there one in the parking lot?
Whoa!
What is it?
That girl dropped a can under her car. Sorry.
Wait, stop, there's our van. She did it. She's guilty. Mom's wrong.
Where's Lois? Did I miss her?
Craig.
You guys are not gonna believe what I have. I have a surveillance arrangement with the manager of the mini mart across the street. We exchanged tapes in order to better understand the security needs of our customers.
Short skirt, windy day?
That's code. Anywho, one of their cameras caught Lois from a different angle right before she got her ticket. See? Lois was right all along. This completely exonerates her. Isn't this great? What are you doing?
You will never, ever tell her of this.
But,
Ever.
Got it.
I just don't see how these guys got in.
It's a mystery.
You left the window open.
Mystery solved.
I'm sorry, what is it you say you're doing here again?
We're watching the cat while the owner's away.
I don't see a cat.
We're not doing a very good job. Hello?
Al?
Oh, Craig, hi! How's the convention?
Fantastic, I picked up some great bargains.
You would not believe some of the idiots that are here. Anyhow, I just called to see how Jellybean's doing.
Oh, fine. He's a frisky little guy, you know. Oh, get off the TV, Jellybean.
That reminds me.
Could you hit the timer button on my VCR? I want to tape Arliss.
Sure. No problem.
Hey, Hal, I don't want you to think I'm weird, but could you put Jellybean on the phone?
Let me just pick him up here. There he is. Okay, I got his ear to the phone.
Hey, Jellybean.
How's my little pussycat? Have you been a good boy while I've been away?
I love you, honey.
Give Daddy a kiss. Jellybean?
Oh, this is ridiculous. Craig has been in there for 45 minutes.
God, I hope I get it. I hope I get it. How many people does he need?
How long is he going to be living with?
Look, we have to be patient with him. We burned the man's house down.
How many boys? How many girls? How many people does he... Look at all the people.
He doesn't like the way I look. He doesn't like the way I dance. He doesn't like the way
That's it. We're opening the door. Someone go get me a coat hanger.
I did that yesterday, Dad. Trust me. Don't go in there. He's done when he's done.
Hey, everyone. Say good morning, Joey Bean.
Oh, dear Lord.
We burned his house down.
Hey, Craig.
So, I overheard your mom talking on the phone, and it's true, you've got a job. I applied here once, didn't get it. It's all politics.
I guess. So what do you want?
I want you to listen very carefully. My blood sugar is dangerously low, so I don't want to burn up any calories repeating myself. I want the jumbo clown burger with the big top fries. No pickles, a slice of onion, make sure it's center cut, and extra tomatoes. And let's do the patty well on one side and medium on the other. And make sure they open a fresh package for my bun. If it's stale, I bail. Seriously.
Total's $5.45 and you get free refills in the soda.
Heard that one before. Turns out it's just for today.
What a sack.
I had to move a couple dozen bags of charcoal briquettes, but I found the slightly darker blue one that you wanted. I got a few spider bites, but none of that matters as long as you, the customer, go home satisfied. You're welcome.
Excuse me, where are your dog toys?
Yes, ma'am. They're right there, right behind you.
Those are leashes.
If I could direct your attention 3 inches to the right.
I want that little hot dog up on top.
Sure thing. I see we have one just like it right here.
That isn't what I asked for. This has mustard on it. Peekaboo doesn't eat mustard.
Well, I can see the one up there has mustard on it too, and since it's not even real mustard...
Are you going to give me what I asked for?
Certainly. There you go. Thanks for shopping Lucky Aid.
This has mustard on it.
That's what I tried to tell you, you old bat! Now you're gonna take it to your dog and make him like it!
Hal, what are you doing here?
Well, you're off work in 5 minutes, and I am here to whisk you away for a night of romance.
Oh, honey, that's so sweet, but I can't. I've got a cover for Craig tonight.
Why?
Oh, he's sick as a dog.
Come on, you know that guy's the biggest faker in the world. The last time he was out with the flu, we saw him jumping up and down in the window on the Today Show.
That doesn't mean I wasn't sick. You didn't happen to tape that, did you? I set my timer wrong.
Oh, honey, I'm so sorry. After all the trouble you went through.
No, it's no big deal. Really, it wasn't any trouble.
Thanks again for the ride home.
Wow.
So this is what it would have been like to go to my prom.
All I wanted was a nice evening with my wife.
I even dug up the wedding vows I never was able to read to her.
What happened?
Well, she went into labor with Francis in the middle of the ceremony. I was going to read them to her tonight.
God, now I feel awful.
Don't worry about it, Craig. It's not your fault.
No, I really feel awful.
Anymore.
Ready? On three. One, two, three.
Go, 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 go. Good job. Go, go.
Craig's a good guy. He always comes through for us.
I couldn't find any rusty scissors, so we're gonna have to use...
Weren't you in here the other day?
No, I don't...
Okay, look, I just want to buy a present for my son, okay? I don't think that's a crime. As I see it, my only crime is not knowing as much as you. Look, you all have parents, don't you? I am appealing to you as decent human beings to help me give my son a happy birthday.
Hey, man, I'm sorry. I guess we did kind of get off on the wrong foot. We all got to start somewhere.
This one's called Dead Man's Shoes.
It's $50. Ooh. It's all about alienation. I think your son will really like it.
Thank you.
Not so fast. The transaction does not concern you, Feldspar.
That's Craig Feldspar. He's a level 45 dungeon master.
What cereal box did you shake this out of, Dean?
It's the first print. It's totally collectible.
Oh. Should we check the Overstreet? Wait. We don't have to. 1997, first and only printing. 50,000 returns, all in circulation. I'd keep this in my bathroom, but not for reading. This isn't a comic book store. It's a novelty shop.
Oh, really? Well, I'd like to see the novelty shop that carries an original Spider-Man number 14 with the first appearance of the Green Goblin.
You're kidding.
And if you change to a more respectful tone, it just might like...
What are you doing? Fear not. It is the 1993 reprint. If it had been an original, he would have thrown himself in front of it.
Dude, you told me that was real.
Now,
let's talk business.
Craig, I can't thank you enough. That was fantastic. You were so heroic.
I like to think we all have a little bit of Aquaman right here.
Well, I must say, you really know your stuff. I'm impressed.
Well, you know, if you're interested, there is a convention next Saturday.
I have a life, Craig.
I swear to God, if you don't drive me, I will leave home forever. Or I'll never leave. Whatever's worse. It's your choice, pal. I think you're gonna like this.
Yeah, yeah, I get it. I put it in my mouth, your toenail clippings are in it, I spit it out, and you've got it all on video. It's been done.
I'm so sorry about that. But we've both grown up a lot since then, and I have a proposal I think you might find interesting. It's still warm. Now, I know a hip guy like you keeps up with the current music scene. It's awfully short notice, and you're probably not even available.
What are you talking about?
There's a concert this Saturday, and Allison and I were wondering if you'd like to go.
You want me to go to a concert with you?
Yeah, pretty much. But the real fun part is the drive there and the drive back. But I don't have to tell you, right? I mean, look who I'm talking to. A single, middle-aged guy with a cat. You know all about the dating scene.
Well, sure, that's my rep, but...
I mean, it's not like you're even excited to go out on a real date. It's not like it's something that you'd be bragging about for weeks.
Of course not. I mean, who cares? But if people were to ask, I'm not forbidden to tell them, am I?
Not at all. This is gonna be great.
And you say I can tell people, right? 13, I got my first velour shirt, and everything changed. Suddenly, there was an opening in the astronomy club. People started sitting on my side of the bus. But I'm a Libra, so I like to think the best of people.
So, Craig, I was telling Allison how well you focus on your driving.
No, you were just telling me that if I really loved you, I'd let you get under my...
So you guys like to take long walks on the beach? I sure do. Plus, I'm a grandmaster at Battleship. I've got the hat if you'd like to see it. So, Allie, do you have any brothers or sisters? What do you think you're doing? You don't talk to me, you just start kissing? I am a person, and I deserve some conversation and some of the social niceties before the kissing starts.
You know what? I was okay when he pulled over twice to change his shirt, but I really don't think he should be yelling at me.
Okay, don't freak out. I can handle this. My family kind of owns him. You know, Craig, another thing girls really like is the strong, silent type. Craig, you just passed the concert.
Oh, no, I don't think so.
But there was a sign, and it had an arrow, and we're supposed to follow the pointy end.
Oh, come on. There's other fun things we can do. I thought we'd start with a hayride, and then a light dinner at Cicero's. I already tipped the violinist to drop by our table, for the lady. Then I thought we'd cap off the evening with a nice romantic bonfire at the lake.
Craig, you are ruining our date.
Now listen here. Do you know how long I have dreamed and planned for this night? 34 years! And I am not gonna let you little brats ruin it! We are gonna have a hayride and dinner and a bonfire, and this is gonna be a magical evening that will live in our hearts forever!
What's that on your glasses?
What? Ah! Oh my God! Reese! You said she'd be nice to me! You said she'd like me!
Yeah, let's ditch this loser. Okay, okay. See you at school.
This is great, isn't it?
Alice is nice, but I have to say, I think a date's better with just two people.
Can we stop calling this a date?
Well, whatever it is, I can't wait to see the look on my neighbor's face when I come strolling home after 11. Eat your heart out, Mrs. Clevisall.
I think I just missed my curfew.
There are no curfews on a night like tonight.
Here I am, the one that you love, asking for another day. Understand, the one that you love, loves you in so many ways.
Hey, I'm gonna do a load of colors, then a load of whites, so if you have any clothes in your room you want...
Craig's been over here every day helping out with the chores since Mom went to her sister's. It was 2 weeks before we figured out, nobody asked him. So Dad's in charge.
Oh my God, honey, I just had the worst dream. The boys just, I just lost control of them and you were never coming home and it was just awful.
It's okay, sweetie. Go back to sleep. We'll spoon, okay?
Okay.
This better be good. There'll be hell to pay if Jellybean wakes up from her massage and doesn't see me on the table next to her.
Oh my God. Is that an Ortair?
It's a Nortair 680B. It's like the first personal computer ever made. You have an interest in this type of stuff, don't you?
There aren't many of these left. I'll give you $5 for it.
Yeah, right. I checked online. This is in mint condition. It's worth at least $1,300.
Deal. No takebacks, double black magic, tap it, bomb it, flush it down the toilet. You understand it's gonna take me a couple days to get the money.
That's exactly what I want. I want you to buy it this Saturday at our garage sale, in front of everybody, with cash. You're gonna react in horror when I tell you Reese was gonna throw this in the trash. And then you're gonna tell everyone they should have listened to me all along.
You know, right now you're sounding a lot like a James Bond villain.
Me? There's nothing wrong with me. I'm fine. And right. And right. And on Saturday, everyone's gonna know it.
Okay, but these revenge plans have a way of backfiring. Word to the wise, if you ever make someone an X-Lax milkshake, don't do it on an empty stomach.
This is just what you need. Remember? Job, people, a life.
But why here?
Because this is the only guy I know that would trade a job interview for a Hong Kong food lunchbox.
Greetings, Earthlings.
You've got to be kidding me.
Trust me, I know it's gonna be hard. But if you can just keep your mouth shut for 5 minutes with this guy, you're home free.
I'm waiting, Princess.
My resume?
Forget this. You can't learn anything from a resume. So, tell me about your employment history.
Well, I...
Interesting. You know, I like to think of Lucky Aid is a kind of family. And in this family, I'd be your father. And as a father, there might be things I might ask of you that don't make sense, but you do it because I'm your father. No sassing back, just do it. Understand?
I think so.
Now, who are you in this family? Are you the second cousin? Or maybe the kooky aunt?
Well, you know, I've always kind of seen myself in the role of the younger brother. Eager to learn.
I never had a brother.
He's been yammering nonstop for almost an hour. He even made Leonard follow him into the bathroom. But Leonard's tough.
Now, let's talk about respect. Not self-respect, but respect for one's superiors. Now, I remember a time, think quick! That's just a little management test I came up with to see whether you're the type of person who confronts problems head on or avoids them. Which one were you? Good. And I see that you have no spine. Welcome aboard. Come back in an hour, we'll get you a trainee vest and a name tag.
Congratulations, I knew you could do it.
Oh,
Oh my God, that guy's an idiot.
You only had to do an interview with him. Try having dinner with that jackass and his stupid cat.
The cat can't be any stupider than this guy. This moron just tried to use a Barbie doll to explain the hygiene procedures.
Brother, huh? I think I'll stay an only child, thank you.
Doc, Doc! Lois, I need to borrow a coat hanger. I dropped my sandwich underneath my car seat. What's going on here?
Lois is in labor and Hal's not here.
I have dreamed of this moment. Here's what we're gonna do. I'm gonna carry you in my arms to my van. I have one of the three original sirens from Starsky and Hutch. I can make that trip in 7 minutes flat.
You're talking crazy. There were only two sirens used in the entire series, and they're both in the Smithsonian.
Au contraire, there were four sirens. I have one of the only three.
Oh, Hal, where are you?
Hey, Craig.
When will J-Lo learn? Take it from a bad boy, we're nothing but trouble. Ooh, you're buying the Tidy Winks.
Yes, and I'm in kind of a hurry.
I don't want to criticize, but I think I know why you're buying the Tidy Winks. It's the absorbency, right? People always fall for that. But what they forget is the elasticity in the legs is suspect at best.
Craig, I just...
You know, since I'm kind of little Jamie's unofficial second alternate godfather, I've been doing some research, and I recommend you take a look at the baby naps. They've got this polymer-based fabric that not only has remarkable wicking capability, but actually...
Craig, for God's sakes, I'm in a hurry. Now, I just want the Tidy Winks, okay? I don't have time for a big discussion. Now, please, will you just ring me up?
Certainly. That'll be $7.98.
Craig, don't make a thing out of this.
Why, whatever do you mean, Hal?
I'm sorry that I snapped at you before, but I really need these diapers. Can you loan me the money?
I could loan you the money, Hal, but that would be helping you. And since you have a tendency to yell at people who try to help you, I don't think that's the wisest course of action for me to take.
Look, Lois will pay for these tomorrow when she comes in.
You can't take those! That's shoplifting!
Fine, then I'm shoplifting! What are you gonna do about it?
Vernon! Just as a crust, I have to have it scraped off by...
Just get her!
Vernon! Don't get too down about this probation thing. This job is mostly a beauty pageant.
You know what's weird? You get used to thinking of a person as being so much more powerful than you. Then something shifts and it becomes kind of awkward.
Oh my God, are you my boss now?
What?
This is so unfair. Year after year, why can't... It's nice to see one of the good guys win. Once you take a load off, I'll go get you a cup of Joe. No worries, Chief. I don't know why you won't let me help you with that, Lois.
Craig, please, I really don't want you to.
Why not?
Because every time you come in contact with me and my family, something horrible happens to you. I can't deal with the guilt anymore.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Come on, if it weren't for us, you'd still have all your teeth. You wouldn't flinch every time you saw a ceiling fan. Your car never would have been filled with bees.
Coincidences.
Craig, you broke your foot looking up a phone number for me.
Please, Lois, it's Christmas.
Here. Maybe you can fluff up the cotton on Santa's beard.
Thank you.
Ow! Oh!
Well, I wish I could say I was surprised.
Oh, and you better be wearing a cup.
I know you've heard the rumors, and all I can say is I might or might not have been scouted by the Kyoto Crazy Phantoms. But don't worry, I play for Lucky 8. Now, watch me carefully, because I only work at one speed, lightning.
This one's for you, Malcolm! Try again! Here's another one!
Is she crazy? How does she expect... Craig, that was amazing!
What were you expecting? I told you I was good.
Polly, are you okay?
Fine. I just seem to be having an out-of-body experience, which my shaman would be very proud of, but I think I'm gonna be falling down now.
Oh, I've got you, baby.
He's here, Angel. You.
Boys, please, please. Now, every conflict invites a dark angel and an angel of light, so let's summon an angel of light.
I have waited for this moment.
Not as much as I have.
How do you know how much I have?
Abe, come on. No, Hal. He's made a fool of me for the last time.
Craig, don't do this.
I will not stand by and let him put the horns on me, Lois.
Than a gym, and no shower bullies.
You're great!
Well, I'm kind of a legend around here.
You're staying out of the ball pit, right, Feldspar?
Yes, sir, you were quite clear on that. Hey, hop on up, Hal, it's a blast. Beat it, Davey.
It's
the spooky happening!
Come on, it's easy, just watch the screen, put your feet where it says.
Let's try it. $200 worth of quarters.
Can't one of you have a heart attack so the rest of us can play?
In a second. Showtime!
Yes!
I think we're finally ready. I didn't want to say anything until I was sure, but I signed us up for the weekly tournament.
No, it's too soon.
Hal, you don't work this hard just to jump dance alone in your room? Besides, someone has to teach Haley and Kylie not to be so stuck up just because they think they're so great.
You can't enter the tournament. You're gonna look like idiots.
We're not done rehearsing. We'll be a lot better by then.
No, you're gonna look like idiots because it's a contest for kids.
It doesn't say that anywhere. I read the rules 3 times, and we're under the weight limit. You can call the manufacturer.
10 messages from Dewey's counselor. Maybe I should...
Practice so we could win this thing?
Right. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, and boogie shake. Boogie shake and slide and slide. These jazz shoes have really helped my kick turns. Totally worth $150.
Hal.
Uh-oh, here comes Yoko.
It's 5 o'clock in the morning. You've been up all night.
Honey, I know you think this is silly and that I've just gone off the deep end again, but this isn't like the other times. I have a gift, Lois, and it would be wrong for me to turn my back on that.
Right. I see we've entered phase 2, which is fine as long as you follow the rules. You have to go to work. You have to eat. You cannot involve the children.
And you're freezing the joint account.
Did it last week. Good night, Fred. Ginger.
Thought it was Fred and Barney.
Oh, that was just great. Which kids are yours?
Those two.
You guys are totally gonna be my new save screen.
Don't let it get to you, Hal. Soon they're gonna feel as stupid as they think we look. Let's rock.
Hey, I thought we're supposed to have the same costume.
They're almost the same.
Whoa!
Ow! My ankle's twisted. Once again, I fly too close to the sun.
But we have to dance.
I can't, Hal. But you have to go on. We've worked too long and too hard to stop now. Now go out there and win that coupon for two free medium pizzas for both of us.
What's that?
Hmm?
I threw that picture away.
Oh, we still have the negative. It reminds me of the old you, back when you still knew right from wrong.
Just because I'm not doing what you want doesn't mean you get to humiliate me.
Humiliate you? You mean there's an offensive image on display in the store?
My son used to love to play dress up just like that. Give him a call.
Take that down!
Gee, I'm not doing what you want. You're not doing what I want. Maybe we should bring Mr. Cushell into this, since he's the only one whose opinion you seem to care about.
No employee may display personal items in his or her workspace. Don't worry, Mom. It only added a day to your probation.
I'm sorry, God. You're against the rules here.
I don't know who I am anymore.
We got slammed with the wedding party and we're way behind.
Ah, the human volcano, one of my favorites.
Oh, it's so much better now that he can read minds.
Exactly. He used to just have heat grip. How lame was that? You allergic to nuts?
No.
All right. What were you studying in school?
Regular stuff, I guess. I don't really like school. Everybody makes fun of me.
Yeah, I remember those days. Kids can be so cruel. The smart kids, the loners, they were the meanest.
The worst is gym class. My own team throws the ball at me in dodgeball.
Hey, you know how you can get out of gym? Pretend to have asthma. All you need is a fake inhaler. Here, take mine. It also gets me good seats on the bus. Don't worry. Things are going to be better for you from here on out.
My dad tells me the same thing.
Well, your dad's a smart man.
Frank, your new haircut looks great. Let me just get my purse and I'll drive you back home to your parents. Craig, you know Frank's parents, Fred and Paula. Remember, Fred is our boss at Lucky Aid, and I believe you're giving golf lessons to his mom. Let's go, Frank. And I promise I'll drive very safely so we don't have an accident. I wouldn't want to ruin your life with my carelessness.
Working on the Texas two-step tonight.
We never see each other anymore. Lois, I see you more than I see my wife these days.
Oh, Fred, things have a way of changing for the better. You'll see.
Attention, Lucky 8 shoppers. My name is Craig Feldspar, and I have a message for Paula Lynch. Paula, I can't go on like this. I'm going to do the right thing and make you my wife.
Are you hearing?
I just bought an $11,500 engagement ring, which I hope you'll accept.
You're cheating on me with Craig Feldspar?
I think we're both victims here, Fred.
I'm gonna go something that way.
Sure, it won't be easy for us, but the path of true love never did run smooth. We'll move in with my grandmother and care for...
Morning, everybody.
Hey, Craig. Thanks for offering me a ride to work today. That's nice of you.
My pleasure. Hey, gee whiz, you know who I haven't seen in the longest time? Your boys. I think I'll just drop in and say an innocent hello. Hey, boys, what do you say? The four of us have a giant tickle party. Okay, that was just a cover. I didn't want to alarm your parents.
What's going on?
I need you guys to teach me how to fight. There's this jerk who's always picking on me, and I'm sick of it.
Why are you asking us?
Because this guy's stronger and faster than me. The only chance I've got is if I fight dirty. And let's face it, your family's legendary for that.
Well, people exaggerate.
Please, you've got to teach me everything you know.
I don't think that's such a great idea. I mean, I teach you some tricks, you teach them to someone else, he teaches them to another guy, and sooner or later, I'm in a fair fight.
Sorry, Craig.
What am I supposed to do? I came to you guys asking for help because that's what I thought friends do for their friends.
Dude, calm down.
I thought we meant something to each other. I mean, after all these years, after everything I've done for you...
Craig, stop it.
I can't help it.
Okay, I guess we can teach you a few moves. Just stop crying.
Really? I mean, you're not just saying that? You'll teach me how to fight dirty?
Yes, but you're going to have to fully commit to this. And you need to know that once you start training with us, you're going to see the world differently.
And there's nothing we can ever do to restore your innocence.
Thank you so much. You guys are the best.
You hug me and the lesson starts right now. Welcome you to the first day of your new, more vicious life. I give you the human body. For clarity, we've divided it into the three major theaters of operation. The head, the torso,
and what are those?
You know what those are. Now, the first thing you need to know is that this is all about pride. Do you have pride, Craig?
Yes.
Okay, that is not the answer I was looking for. You show me a man with pride, and I'll show you a man with limited options. Let's say that this is your opponent, and he's coming after you. Hey, man, we can work this out. I didn't know she was your girl. See? Now he's blind, and he had the time to really get creative. Personally, I like to leave at least one sense intact so he knows what's happening to him.
I knew I came to the right place.
Okay, Dewey, you're up.
Okay, first I'm gonna need you to take off your glasses.
Ow, my eyes! I didn't know we were starting!
There is no starting in dirty fighting. Life is one big fight from the day you're born to the day you die. Okay, maybe we should slow down a little.
Time out! Time out!
You think we're wasting our time here?
Let's just kick him in the kidneys and call it a night.
No! Please! I know I suck, but I want to be better. Please, I'll try harder, I promise!
Let me try something. All right, Craig, listen. I want you to think. I want you to visualize every bully that ever picked on you or beat you up. Really see the look of contempt on their faces as they pounded on you. You got it? Now, picture what they were looking at.
Oh, it's disgusting!
Is he going for the plums? It appears so.
Well, you sure won't have to worry about the guy's children coming up.
Hey, Malcolm.
At what age do you just accept that your life is a piece of rotten garbage and always will be?
22. But that doesn't mean you can't enjoy the heck out of every moment. Take tonight. You're in for a real treat. There's a different rhythm to the night shift. It's a camaraderie, a brotherhood of kindred souls, a nocturnal fraternity of the prowlers of the inky netherworld. Hello, fellow traveler.
Where's the toothpaste?
I'm on a break.
Make sure all the pens are cap side up with the pocket clip facing forward. This is the benefit of graveyard shift. You don't have all that chaos that goes on during the daytime. You can get things organized the way they're meant to be.
You're just trying to torture me. That's why I'm here. Just admit it.
You're here because you need the money.
I give you 3/4 of my paycheck.
That's why you need the money.
That's weird. Did you see anyone?
What?
Someone left a candy wrapper and change on the counter here, but nobody's been in the store for hours.
It was probably a mouse.
A mouse that left the exact change?
I played tic-tac-toe with a chicken at the county fair, and it beat me 8 times in a row. Don't shortchange animals.
Craig, did you do this?
Do what?
Those vitamins that were recalled. Did you clear off the shelf?
Doesn't sound like me. 6 coats of wax and I buttered up my socks. The record's going down.
You know, things have been getting really weird around here. I mean, think about it. Last night, all the clocks in the display case were synchronized at the same time. And the night before that, all the fingerprints were cleaned off the freezer doors.
Malcolm, I think you're forgetting the graveyard shift motto. Who cares?
Craig, take a look at this.
If you don't mind, I'm trying to get in a quick nap before my break.
Seriously, check out this guy.
He's here. And then 2 hours later, he's still there, only in a different outfit. And 3 hours later, he shows up again in another outfit. Whoa! Did you see that?
Malcolm, please! If I don't get my 16 hours, I'm a bear!
I'm just about to call.
Oh my God! Don't worry, Malcolm! I'll help you!
Sam, you've got to listen to me!
Hang on! Damn it! What aisle are the screwdrivers in? Which batteries are the double A? The little ones or the really little ones?
Sam, please listen. I'm never gonna shake this guy. He's way too good. I can't outstilt him. I can't outstilt him, but I can't outskate him.
Okay, your brother got the funeral he wanted. Now let's get our $15 back.
Ha! Once again, brains triumph over... This shirt's so much worse than it looks.
You're a Yank.
Happy anniversary, Lois. I chewed through my rope so I could have this set up for you before you got back.
Oh, Craig.
I invited the entire staff, but I guess they didn't show up on account of seeing me as human garbage.
I wish you'd be mad at me. Yell at me. Tell me I'm a horrible person, please.
Don't apologize, Lois. If you want to make me happy, just sit down and enjoy your party. Hello, everybody. Here's one I'm sure you'll all remember.
Here she comes now, our Lois, Lois. Strutting down the aisle like she doesn't know us. Hey, she wears a smock and she looks alright, yeah. You got scared and stuck and mocked the cat shell. Meow, 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 yeah. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, 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 yeah. Cause she's been here, kid. Yeah. Through the laugh, through the tears. Punching it, punching out. At that time, she had gout. I said, yeah.
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 This is it, the open road. A great new chapter is about to be written. A new legend about to be born. Will I travel from town to town solving crimes like Knight Rider, or administer frontier justice like the guy from Kung Fu? I guess we'll just have to see. Okay, America, get ready to meet Craig Feldspar.
Wait!
Craig, are
Craig!
Kit, is that you? Just help me back on my hog. I'll be fine. Thanks, I'm good to go.
Oh, Craig, don't be ridiculous. You're not going anywhere.
Why? Do you need somebody to paint your lawn or mow your house?
Look, Craig, Malcolm told me about that. I admit I take you for granted sometimes. I apologize for that, but we can talk about that later. You have to come back.
I can't.
Why, Craig, come on. Aren't you interested at all to see how my mom punishes me?
No.
Why not?
Because for the last 12 years, I've dedicated my life to a relationship that can't exist. I can't go back to that.
Craig, what do you want from me?
I want more.
I'm sorry. I can't give you more. You know that.
There's got to be something. There's got to be some scenario where you could see us together. Please, anything.
Okay, this is the only universe this could possibly exist in. I'm 90 years old. Hal is dead. I have dementia, and I need someone to keep me from catching myself on fire. There's no money for a nurse, the kids won't do it, and I'm asleep 22 hours a day. Then, and only then, maybe, could we be together.
It's like you're reading straight out of my diary.